Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 through 4, from the New King James Version of the Holy Bible. Amen. And it reads, "Take heed that you do not do your charitable deeds before men to be seen by them. Otherwise, you have no reward from your Father in heaven. Therefore, when you do a charitable deed, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do, in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may have glory from men. Assuredly, I say to you, they have their reward. But when you do a charitable deed, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, that your charitable deed may be in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will himself reward you openly." Amen. Let the church say amen again. I want to talk to us from the subject, serve Jesus with a pure heart. Yes. Serve Jesus with a pure heart. In Luke 18, verses 9 through 14, which we had for our scripture reading earlier today, Jesus told a parable about two men who wanted to worship God. One was a Pharisee, and the other was a tax collector. The Pharisees were very religious and respected people in the society, while tax collectors were considered to be sinners and not respected at all. The Pharisee came forward before God confidently and boasted about his righteousness and his good deeds, while the tax collector stood back, bowed his head before God, and pleaded for mercy for his sins. After both men had finished praying, Jesus judged the Pharisee's prayer to be unacceptable to God, while the tax collector's prayer was acceptable. And the conclusion from this parable that Jesus told is that what people may think is righteous may not be righteous in the sight of God. And what men may respect may not even be acceptable to God. The reason is that while men are often impressed by how things look on the outside, God judges things by the condition or attitude of our hearts toward Him. And so today we remind you to serve Jesus with a pure heart. The setting of our text is one of Jesus' best known sermons, known as the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus and his disciples were on a mountain, and they were looking upon the great crowd that followed him everywhere he went. And Jesus began to preach to his disciples about the kingdom, his kingdom, and how he expected people to live in it. He talked about his own kingdom and then differentiated it from the kingdom of men, and spoke to his disciples about his expectations for those who would live in his kingdom. He identified those who would be blessed in his kingdom in what we have come to know as the Beatitudes. He talked about those who would be blessed in his kingdom and pointed out that those who would be blessed in his kingdom may not necessarily be the ones that are blessed in the sight of men. In what we call the similitudes, he identified believers as the salt and the light of this world. He said, you as a Christian have a role to play. You have to be salt. To add flavor and goodness to the world. And you have to be light to dispel the darkness of the world. And then he preached about the condition of man's heart. It is kingdom, the hearts of men, or their abilities, or their attitudes toward God would be more important even than their actions. He went on to say that the priority, that God gives priority to the heart. And this priority that he gives to the heart extends to every aspect of Christian service in the kingdom of God. Meaning that every service that is rendered in God's kingdom, in the kingdom of our Lord Jesus Christ, is judged in terms of the heart or the attitude of the servant. Jesus revealed two basic ways that people can serve in his kingdom. We can serve in his kingdom through our works, or we can serve in his kingdom through our worship. We serve the Lord through our works when we do good deeds, when we go on mission in the world, when we give to the poor and we bless the needy, for example. When we do those things, we are serving the Lord through our works. But we can also serve the Lord through our worship. When we participate in church, when we pray, when we praise him, we preach the word of God, for example, we are serving the Lord through worship. But our Lord Jesus Christ, as he told us about the different ways in which we could serve him, he also talked about the fact that there is a right way and a wrong way to serve the Lord. The right way to serve the Lord in whatever we do is to serve him with genuine love and with a pure heart. But the wrong way to serve the Lord is to do so seeking personal honor instead of God's glory. The essence of today's message is to remind us that the pursuit of personal honor corrupts Christian service. Let me say that again. And say it slowly, that the pursuit of personal honor corrupts Christian service. But God rewards those who serve him with a pure heart. Amen. Our text today reveals three important thoughts that we must remember as we strive to serve our Lord Jesus Christ. And all I'm trying to tell all of us today is to serve Jesus with a pure heart. Three thoughts that come to mind from the pages of the scripture. One, that God rejects any service rendered for personal or public honor. That God rejects any service that is rendered for personal or public honor. This kind of service is often publicized. But this kind of service is pointless in the sight of God. Let us read verses 1 and 2 of our text. Jesus Christ says, take heed that you do not do your charitable deeds before men to be seen by them. Otherwise, you have no reward from your Father in heaven. Therefore, when you do a charitable deed, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may have glory from men. Assuredly, I say to you, they have their reward. God rejects any service that is rendered for personal or public honor. The Lord Jesus Christ was talking about his kingdom, and he told his disciples that when they serve God through their charitable deeds, toward others, giving to the poor, or whatever it was that they did, he said, do not do it to be seen by people. He said, if you do it so that people will see you, so that people will know how much you give, so that people will see you doing whatever it is that you claim to be doing in the name of the Lord, that if you do it for that reason, he said that it is all pointless, because at the end of the day, there is no reward. There is no reward for that kind of service. And the prophet Ezekiel, listen, he talks about it some. If we can find it, put it on the screen. Ezekiel chapter 33 and verse 31. Ezekiel chapter 33 and verse 31. Listen to what Ezekiel said. Talk about it. He said, so they come to you. I'm waiting for it to come on the screen. He said, Ezekiel 33 and 31. He said, so they come to you as people do. They sit before you as my people, and they hear your words, but they do not do them. For with their mouth they show much love, but their hearts pursue their own gain. There are people like that. Even today, not just in the time of Christ, there are people like that in the church of Jesus Christ, even today. They are publicity seekers. They perform greatly before crowds. And when there is a crowd, they perform greatly. But when there is no crowd, they won't perform. They serve greatly in front of people, and people sing their praises. However, their service is rejected by God. And it is totally pointless as far as God is concerned. Though men praise them, God rejects their service outright. And such people, like I said, still exist in the church today. Whenever they give their donations, they want their donation to be seen or announced. When their donation is seen or announced, they give much. But when the donation is not going to be announced or seen, they pout and they complain and they withhold their gift. They are acting like they have never heard what I'm saying. Either that or I'm walking down somebody's street. You've ever seen some people where you go to a party and it's time to give money, they stay long. But if you tell them, oh, don't give like that, they put their money in their pocket. You know why? Because their plan in the giving was not to be a blessing to you, but to be what? Seen. They wanted to be seen. So the moment they cannot give it that way, their preference is to keep their money in their pocket. The Lord Jesus Christ described this type of people as hypocrites. Listen to what he said in verse 2. He said, therefore, when you do a charitable deed, do not sound a trumpet before you as hypocrites do. He described them as hypocrites. Because the truth of the matter is that if their plan was to give you the gift, then it doesn't matter whether they do it like this or they put it in your hand quietly. You understand what I mean? Because their plan was to give you the gift and to let God get the glory. They are not the only people in the church that do that. So other people in the church like to serve when they are seen. They always want to be in front. They always want their names to be mentioned. Young people, you ever see that kid on the basketball court who thinks that he's the best? And whenever you pass the ball to him, you can be sure he's not going to pass it to nobody else. Because he must be the one at the end of the day to score the basketball and get the glory. But a good basketball player is taught that that is not about you, it's about your team. So when you get the basketball, don't be a ball hog and pass it to somebody else. Amen. There are some people, when they are singing, maybe in the choir, they have to have the microphone. You cannot tell them to sit on the, be on the second row. They have the microphone because as far as they are concerned, their voices must be heard. Are you following me? All this kind of service, the Bible says, our Lord Jesus Christ is telling us, this is pointless service. It is meaningless to God because it is not done for God's glory, it is done for your glory. God rejects any service that is rendered for personal honor. But when we read the text, we find that we are called upon to serve Jesus with a pure heart. The second thing that the text reveals to us is that God requires all service to be rendered with pure hearts. God requires all service to be rendered with pure hearts. Why? Because this kind of service is godly. And this kind of service is genuine in the sight of God. God requires all service to be rendered with pure hearts. The Lord talked about one person who serves him for public and personal honor. But he also spoke of another kind of person who serves because he or she truly loves the Lord. These people serve the Lord with a pure heart. They do their charitable deeds quietly without seeking publicity. When they serve in the church, their names do not have to be called. In fact, the way Jesus Christ described it, he said that their service is so private that even their left hand does not know what their right hand is doing. Well, what he said is that they are not after publicity. They are not after everybody to see me and know what I'm doing. In fact, they are so quiet and so simple in what they do that even the left hand does not know what the right hand is doing. He said that their service is pleasing to God because it is according to his will. It is a godly kind of service. How do we know that it is godly? Because it is the way that Jesus Christ told us to serve him. It is godly service. It is pleasing to God because it is not only godly, but it is genuine service. You want to know who really love you? See what they give you when nobody is looking. But don't judge them by how long they are on the dance floor. Don't judge according to that. But see who that person is when the attention and the honor is not for themselves. You want to know who cares? Look at the person behind the scenes. Not the one that is fighting and elbowing everybody to be up front. Young people, even in the church, you ought to be team players. You ought not to be looking for your glory. You want to always be the one that gets all the attention. You may get the attention, but you're not going to get anything else from God. But if you want God to bless you and to reward you, then serve him because you love him. Not because you want people to see you or to call your name. So how are we going to be able to tell if a person is serving you with a pure heart? The Bible tells us about that in Hebrews chapter 4. Hebrews chapter 4 and verse 12 would be helpful. Hebrews 4 and 12. The Bible tells us about how you will know, you can discern a person who is serving you with a pure heart. Look at what it's serving the Lord with a pure heart. He said, listen, for the word of God is living and powerful, and it is sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of the soul and the spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner and the thoughts and the intents of the heart. You want to know if somebody is serving you with a pure heart? Judge what they are doing according to the word of God, because the Bible says that the word of God exposes and reveals the real intention of people's hearts. The Lord Jesus Christ calls upon us to serve him with a pure heart and to be reminded that God rejects any service that is rendered for personal honor and glory. That God requires all service to be rendered with a pure heart. Don't serve the Lord selfishly. Don't serve him for your own glory. Don't serve him for your own aggrandizement. Serve the Lord because you genuinely love him. Any other service is pointless and profitless as far as God is concerned. What good does it do you if you sing in the choir and everybody talks out, you are so wonderful, but God doesn't bless you? Even if nobody says anything to you, but God blesses you, the favor of God will take you far in life. It's not what about what people say. Allow people and give you accolades or praise. It is about the condition of your heart as you serve the Lord. The third thing that our text reveals is that God rewards any service rendered with pure hearts. First of all, God rejects any service that is rendered for public honor or personal honor. God requires all service to be rendered with pure hearts. And finally, God rewards every service, any service that is rendered with a pure heart. This kind of service is recognized by God, and this kind of service is rewarded by God. Listen, in the text, as you read in the text, you find out that of the two kinds of people who attempt to serve the Lord, the service of one is rejected, while the service of the other is rewarded. The one whose service is rejected is the one who comes forward, pushes himself to the front, wants to be as prominent as ever, so that he will get all the glory and all the honor. A service is rejected by the Lord, and it is totally pointless. But the service that is rewarded by the Lord is the one whose service is with a pure heart and with genuine love for God. When you love God and your heart is toward him, every aspect of your service will be for his glory. I discovered that people who serve the Lord for personal honor, one of the things I notice about them is that they are very easily offended. Everything revolves around them. The church should orbit around them. Everything revolves around them. Every conversation, you must be talking about me. Every sermon, somebody told the preacher about me. Everything is about them. Because they are the center of the universe. In their own mind. Amen. Amen. But there are those whom the Lord rewards. And those whom the Lord rewards are not easily offended. You may not greet them, you may not call their name, but they know that what they are doing is not for you anyway, but it is for God. They don't leave church because somebody didn't treat me right last Sunday. They understand that they are in the church not because of you, not because of anybody else, but because of the Lord that they serve. And so their service, even though their service is low-key, sometimes their service is even rendered in secret, but nevertheless it is recognized by God. Just because everybody doesn't see you does not mean that God does not recognize your service. Amen. Amen. The eyes of the Lord, the Bible says, are upon everything that happens, and he certainly keeps his eyes upon the righteous. Though these people, their service may not be acknowledged, and men may not even appreciate their service, God recognizes them. Amen. And there are some like that in the church. A few Sundays ago, maybe about a month ago, we pulled our security ministry workers and brought them before the church. We brought our children's ministry workers before the church because they are serving in places that nobody would know.
Yes, sir.
While you are in the church, singing and dancing, they are the ones outside watching over your car. So that Satan and his evildoers will not do you wrong. They are the ones teaching children that they did not give birth to. And they are doing it many times without even receiving any recognition. But I came to declare that God rewards any service that is rendered to him with a pure heart. Hebrews chapter 6 and 10. Hebrews 6 and 10. In the New King James Version, Hebrews 6 and 10 declares to us, he said, "For God is not unjust to forget your work and your labor of love, which you have shown toward his name, in that you have ministered to the saints and do minister." What it is saying is that God is not an unjust God. Any service that you render, whether people see you, whether people recognize you, whether people reward you or not, that God is the one watching over his church, watching over his people, recognizing who is serving him with a pure heart, and those that are serving him with selfish motives. That God sees it, and God is not an unjust God. There was a place that the Bible said that even those who give a cup of cold water to his prophets will by no means lose their reward. It doesn't matter whether your service is big or whether your service is small. It is not the size of your service that matters, but the condition and the attitude of your heart. Jesus Christ went to the worship in the synagogue, and in the whole synagogue, he only singled out one person to recognize that person's service. He didn't talk about the preacher. He didn't talk about who was singing. He didn't talk about any one of those. He talked about a widow who only gave what? 2 pennies. He recognized her. size of the gift. It was about the condition and the purity of the heart. That is why he talked about those who he said will bless the prophet with even a cup of water. It doesn't matter if you buy your pastor a private jet, but you do it for an ulterior motive. You are better off if you give the prophet of God a cup of water, but you did it with a pure heart. God rewards any service that is rendered with a pure heart. And he rewards it irrespective of the servant and irrespective of the size. If you are rich and you render service to God with a pure heart, God will recognize and reward you. If you are poor and you render service to God with a pure heart, God will recognize and reward you. If you are a man and you recognize, you serve him with a pure heart, he will recognize and reward you. If you are a woman, he will recognize and reward you. If you are a child or a youth, he will recognize and reward you. If you are a young adult, he will recognize and reward you. He will recognize and reward you regardless of the servant and regardless of the size of your gift or the service that you render. As I come to a close, I remind us once again to serve Jesus with a pure heart. Because God rejects any service that is rendered for personal or public honor. God requires all service rendered with pure heart. And God rewards any service that is rendered with pure heart. So for those of you who are the saints of God today, those of you who have already believed in God in your heart, I remind you of the word of God in Matthew chapter 5 and verse 8. Matthew 5 and verse 8, in what we know as the Beatitudes of the Sermon on the Mount, listen to what Jesus Christ said. He said, blessed are the pure in heart. Why? Because they shall see God. What does he mean by the fact that the pure in heart shall see God? What he means is that the pure in heart, they will see God by faith while they are in this world. And they will see the Lord. They will see him, like we say, face to face when we go up into glory. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God by their faith. They will be encouraged. Those who serve God with a pure heart, they serve him. And I know sometimes they are criticized. They are criticized by others who do not see God. But they serve God by faith because they see him. They see him by faith. They see him in their service. They see him walking with them side by side. They see him encouraging them. The Bible of our Lord Jesus Christ said, when your heart is pure toward God, you shall see God. Yes, there are many people in the church, unfortunately, who don't see God. They don't see him because everything that they are doing is according to the flesh. According to what they can see, what they can feel. According to how their calculator adds up the mathematics. Everything they do is according to the flesh. But the Lord Jesus said that if your heart is pure, he will open up your eyes so you will see him. Jesus was going to serve thousands of people who were hungry. Thousands of people were hungry, and Jesus decided, said, let us serve them. And the disciples came, and they told Jesus, they said, oh, Jesus, look at what we found. All we have is these 5 barley loaves and these 2 fishes. How can we serve more than 5,000 people with this? Jesus said, bring it to me. And when they brought the thing to Jesus. The Bible said the first thing Jesus did was he started thanking God. What is the difference between Jesus and his disciples? One of them saw God, and the others did not. The disciples did not see God. If they had seen God, they would have known that it was no problem for God to feed thousands. But they did not see God, so they told Jesus, send everybody home. Oh, Pastor, we cannot do that. The money is not enough. But when you see God, all in here. I said, when you see God, your problem, no matter how big the problem is, it will become small when it is put side by side with the size of your God. Ask your neighbor, do you see God? Do you see him in your circumstance? Do you see him working in your family? Do you see him working in your marriage? Do you see him working in your business? Do you see him working on your job? Do you see him in your school? How about do you see him in your church? Those who are pure in heart, blessed are the pure in heart, because they shall see God. I want to see God in everything I do. I want to see God when I stand up to preach his word. I want to see God when I put my hand in my pocket to write my offering check. I want to see God when I visit the sick in the hospital, or when my loved ones are sick. I want to see God in everything that we are doing in the church. When the enemy shall rise up against me like a flood, I want to see God because I know that the Spirit of God will raise up a standard against me. No matter what Satan may be planning in my life, I want to see God because I know that no weapon that is fashioned against me shall be able to prosper. God encouraging me and saying, my son, keep on, keep it on. I want to see God in the ministry of our youth and our young adults. You and young adults, let your heart be filled with God so that you can see God for yourself. Some people can never see God in their church. They only see him in another place. But if you only open up your eyes and be pure in your heart, so that you will see God for yourself. Because I came to declare that you are God and majority wherever you are. In God before us, who can be against us? In God is on our side. Who will stop the curse? Was concerned because he thought that he died his death on the cross. Can we stop playing games? Why are you rushing to be in the front? We're rushing to be the one whose voice is always heard. You don't have to win every argument. You don't have to have the final say. You see God. The only person who is pushing to go to the front is the person who has not seen God. But when you see Him, no matter what what goes on in your life, you will recognize that God is able to lift you up. That's why Jesus Christ said, "Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done." Because he saw God, because his heart was pure. Thank you.